Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're going to check out the Rockwood 23IKSS. This is definitely one of our more popular floor plans for a few reasons. One, it's a Rockwood, which it's super popular because of the construction. Two, you have a double slide out. So you have opposing slide outs that really opens up the inside. And of course you have the tip out beds over here. That gives you the extra sleeping space without taking up your living space. Let me show you a few features on the outside and then we'll go on to the inside. Starting off on the rear of the coach, I wanted to show you a couple things. One, this canvas material is more of a vinyl material instead of a normal canvas material. The reason why that's important is because this is gonna protect you a little bit better in water. Two, the stitching is all UV protected stitching, so it's not gonna degrade over time. And this is also permanently sealed right here. So what that means is you don't have to worry about setting this up, having bungee cords that pop off over time, kids rolling out of bed, your cell phone falling on the ground. This just makes it a lot nicer. Two, you do also have these breathable panels. So that makes the coach be able to breathe better even if they're zipped up all the way. Another thing, you have an outside grill. Now this guy can move left or right a little bit if you want to. It has the quick connect propane. This guy just hooks right into the grill itself. And then when the grill's not here, you can use a 110 outlet, your coax cable, and put your TV out here. And this is a bracket built in for that. This awning is a power awning. It's the Dometic one, so it runs at twice the speed the other types of awnings do. You can also adjust it so that you can pitch it this way or that way so that the water sifts off one way or the other. You also have the awning lights underneath so that you can be able to see at night and light up your whole area. You also have outside speakers, one's on this side, and then you have another one on this side. Another thing that I wanted to show you is this guy does have the torsion suspension axles, aluminum rims, so that is gonna make it so that the wheels won't rust over time. The torsion suspension means you're gonna have independent suspension as you're pulling it down the road. They have a 10-year warranty on it, one of the best in the industry. Over here, you'll notice you have a triple entry step, so that just makes it easier to get in and out of the coach. Also, the reason why it's triple entry is because this guy does have a little extra clearance underneath there. That's because of that Torflex suspension, puts you off the ground a little bit. This door also has a friction hinge built into it. What that means is instead of having to clip this onto the side of the coach and forgetting about it and pulling on it and ripping out the screws, this guy can handle up to a 20 mile per hour wind and won't move on you. You also have the screen door, and then if you have little kids hanging out with you, you can also throw this in front of it so that when they try to get out, they're not rolling down the steps. And then you can keep this open for some extra light and some extra breeze through the camper. Also, this guy has the ZAMP plug-in, so that's a solar plug-in that you can hook up your solar panel, put it in the sunlight while your camper is underneath the shade maybe, and be able to charge your batteries back up. You can charge your batteries one of three ways really. One is through the solar panel, two is by your truck, or three by pedestal or generator power at the campsite itself. Another cool thing is you have a power tongue jack. Now this guy does have a light built into the front so that when you're hooking and unhooking, you can see what you're doing, as well as a secondary light. These are LED lights, not only on the outside of the camper, but on the inside of the camper so that it doesn't drain your battery nearly as fast. Two 20 pound tanks, and then you have a hard shell protecting your propane tanks instead of a soft shell. That means this is gonna last you a lot longer. Another thing to point out, this guy weighs 5,500 pounds dry. Now that is going to not include your water weight, your propane weight, all your camping gear. The GVWR on this guy is 6,500 pounds. So that gives you about 1,000 pounds worth of cargo that you can put in the camper if you want to. You also have pass-through storage. You can access it from this side or the other side, and you can actually access it from the inside as well. There's some cabinet doors inside there. You have four manual stabilizer jacks, one on each corner. You can, what I recommend is there's a manual crank in this camper that you can put them down that way, or you can just hook up that same 3/4 inch socket to your cordless drill and zip them down that way. That actually makes it so that it's a little bit stronger and stays in place a little bit stiffer than the electric kinds, and probably is about 3 times faster. You also have a little storage pocket right here. This is in the slide out of the coach, and this is underneath the dinette that you can access also from the inside if you need to. Over here, you do have a black tank sewer flush, so that's a really nice feature. Instead of having to drag a water hose inside your camper down the toilet and putting a spray nozzle on that and maybe making a mess, hopefully not, this guy, you just hook up a water hose right to here, it sprays out the tanks for you. Outside shower with both hot and cold water ran to it. There's, you can set the temperature however you like, and then there's a little button right here to turn it on and off once you have the temperature the way you like it. 30 amp connection, you also have the LED light that lights up as soon as you're connected. That way, if you're having problems with power, you can tell if it's from the pedestal or the generator or something inside. This is just a nice, easy troubleshoot thing. Maybe you didn't have it connected in all the way. This will help you out. Cable satellite connections here, antifreeze inlet. This is another nice feature. So if you want to winterize your coach, which you need to do in the wintertime, there's a valve that you turn on in this inside the coach. You hook up your antifreeze tube here with your jug of antifreeze, and you can suck that antifreeze through using your water pump instead of having to take apart your water pump each time to be able to pull that off. This is a gas electric hot water heater. So instead of giving you the normal 7 to 10 gallons of hot water per hour, this will give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour because you can run it off gas, electric, or both at the same time. And then you also have a port for a backup camera, which we sell in our parts store. Basically, you just pull off the plate there, plug in your backup camera, and you're set to go. That way you can see what you're doing as you're pulling it down the road, seeing if somebody's tailgating you, as well as avoiding that tree or camper as you're backing in. And then last but not least, you have another storage area back here. Just a tiny little area to work with. And then also, I'll point out that this is a hard shell instead of a soft shell. Again, that won't look ratty after a couple years. It'll stay nice years to come. All right, guys, come on inside. I want to show you a few things on the inside of the coach. And as you can see, there is tons of room to work, even with that middle island, which people love this. So this is called the 23IKSS, so that's island kitchen. And then SS is super slide, meaning that the slide out, it has both the dinette and the couch, which really opens it up. So this is about a 3-foot slide here. The kitchen is slid out, and that's about a 2-foot slide. Let me start off over here. As you walk inside, you'll notice there's spots to put whatever, like kick off your shoes inside here, extra coats racks. This guy folds away if you want this off and just use this as coats, or if you need extra pantry space, you have that as well. You'll also notice all the cabinetry is this raised panel cabinetry, so it's a little bit nicer cabinetry than you see in a lot of the other campers out there. This is an inner spring mattress instead of just a mattress pad. So if you look at a lot of the competition, it's not nearly this thick. It doesn't have the springs. This one's actually heated. So if you wanted to be able to use your little dial to turn it from 1 to 6 or 0 to 6, you can do that. And then another thing that I like about these guys that not everybody does, I don't know if you can see this. You'll have to kind of crawl on here, Octavio. But there's this metal bar right back here. This goes the entire length back here, and that's important. The reason why that's important is because over time, if you're laying down on here, this will tend to bow out on a camper. And that bow, when you fold this whole thing up, that's where rain and dust and everything else can get inside. With that bar, that's added structure that you don't have to worry about that. I've noticed the other guys are still not doing that. Rockwood, having 40 years of experience underneath their belt, they've kind of learned a few tricks of the trade. Over here on this side, you'll notice that you have a very nice stereo system. This is the IRV Technology Stereo. It does have the built-in DVD player. It does have the built-in 5-volt charger to quickly charge your cell phone. Also the aux in and the HDMI and the Bluetooth built into it. So you can control on your smartphone the volume as well as the songs that you're playing out in your campfire area. And turn on your outside speakers, all from this guy here. TV, this guy is on a swing arm, so if you wanted to, I mean, it's at a pretty good viewing angle from the couch, which is kind of nice. Some of those, they put the TV actually over on this side, which doesn't quite make as much sense. This is a great spot for it because it's good viewing for both the dinette and the couch. And then if you wanted to angle it while you're hanging out in the kitchen, you can do that. Or that bracket also goes outside, so if you wanted to angle it and watch the game outside, you can do that too. Over in the, here in the kitchen, you'll notice that you have full pull-out drawers. They're the nice metal glide drawers, and they have that click at the end so that they stay shut as you're moving down the road. And that Torflex suspension makes it so that all this stuff doesn't go everywhere while you're pulling it down the road. A few of the fun things are in here. So this guy is a fan slash light combo. This guy just plugs in right here and then hooks onto here. So you can hook it there or hook it this way, and then you can use it as an extra reading light or whatever. You get two of those in here, and we'll keep them both in here for you. You also get a spot to put your paper towel holder. You can put this wherever, you know, whether it's here or on the side, it's up to you. And then these are those heated mattress controllers. So you can plug these into the mattress, plug them into a 110 outlet, and you're set to go. 10,000 gallon water filtration system. This filters all the water in the entire unit. That keeps your weight down so you don't have to bring all the water with you at the beginning of your trip, so that you save on, you know, gas mileage as well as just overall weight. And then all your tanks stay a lot cleaner too. So all your lines and everything like that, it's filtered down to 0.9 micron, which is a residential grade filter. Forest River spatula. So not only do you get that outside grill, you also get a little table that fits right next to the grill, and a cool spatula with a bottle opener on the end of it. And it's really nice. It's a nice wooden handle all the way through. Yeah, and you can just see these drawers are huge. So four drawers over here, two large drawers here, plus underneath storage that goes all the way back here if you need to. And then counter space galore, especially since they made this a flush mount and this a flush mount. So you can use this as an extra cutting board if you need to. High-rise sink faucet, very deep sink inside there. And then this is flush. You have a knife rack back here, and then this guy does fold up to the back, so it adds as a natural backsplash. This is a mini blind, whereas all the other blinds in the coach, they're actually going to be this pleated nightshade. So this is a little bit nicer shade, but what they do is back here, just for fire code reasons, they make this a mini blind. Also easy to clean up if you have some splatter going on. And all these windows are the rain windows. So the way that works is I can just twist this open. And this opens up the window on the bottom. So if you noticed outside, that window doesn't have a grommet around it, so it's not gonna dry out over time and crack and leak. And if it's raining outside, you can still get some airflow moving through the camper. 22 inch oven right here, so that's a bigger oven as opposed to the normal 17, where they shrink this about half, so you can barely fit anything on in this guy. This one is a lot nicer. And then that just folds across. More storage here, as well as inside here, and I'll keep it inside here for you guys. This is a explanation of how to run the TV and the DVD player. So if you're not tech savvy, you have all the instructions right there, easy to work with. Microwave right there, and then if that wasn't enough storage already, you also have this pantry area. This is cool too. This is a roadside assistance, 24/7 coach net, a phone number to be able to call them up and say, hey, I'm in the middle of Timbuktu, can you help me find the nearest RV service center? You can call these guys and they can walk you through a lot of that stuff. This guy, this has the nicer handles to be able to open and close your refrigerator. Some of them you have to like push a button and then pull, so it's not as intuitive as these type. This is a gas electric refrigerator, so this can run off of electric power, so if you're plugged in at like a generator or a pedestal, you can do that. Or if you want to just run off propane, it works very efficiently that way too. That's important if you're not always plugged in at a campsite so that you can keep your food cold. So sleeping wise, this guy has a lot of sleeping capacity. Very comfortable couches. You'll notice this is very cushy back here and they come off. And I want to show you how this folds into a bed because it's a little bit simpler than a lot of them out there. This is a tri-fold sofa. So instead of just a jackknife sofa, we've decided to upgrade this one with the option of the tri-fold. That makes it so that two adults can fit on here instead of like just a three-year-old. So yeah, that's how it folds out. This is like a memory foam type of material. It's very nice. And then this guy folds up just as easily. And then this guy folds into a bed as well. So really you can sleep 2, 4, 6, 8 people total in this coach. Now this table is removable. So if you want to take this outside and use it as a picnic table, you can. There's a button right here that you click, and then this guy just folds onto those rungs that are built into this coach right here. And then these guys on the backside make into the bed. You'll notice you also have storage above both the couch and the dinette, as well as the nice little reading lamp. So these guys move, they're all LED. You know, a lot of guys, they'll just include the one light. But these guys, you know, they've made nice little touches everywhere. Another thing that you'll notice is this roof is barreled, so it's kind of got a curve to it. So not only does that make it feel a little bit more open inside here, it also wicks the water away from your roof so you don't have standing water. Two, you'll notice this guy has not only one, but two max air vent fans. And the other cool thing is they put covers over both of them. So even if you have this fan open, you don't have to worry about water getting in here, which that's unfortunately a common occurrence. So, you know, you open it up to get some air through here, you forget about it, you shut the door, big rainstorm comes in here, you have a giant water that's, you know, if your camper's tilted one way or another, it goes towards the nice wood on the bottom of the floor. And then, you know, you can imagine replacing wood and stuff like that in a coach is a pain in the butt. This happens to be a 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking instead of OSB chipboard. So if that for some reason did happen to you, you're a little bit better protected than a lot of the competition. I would say about 90% of the guys out there, if they're not Forest River, are you using OSB chipboard in their floors. Another thing that you'll notice is this guy can run off the battery. Your air conditioner cannot. You'll be plugged into a generator or pedestal power, but you'll notice this is double ducted. So the way this guy works is you can open these guys up and you can also turn them. That's nice too, because if you want to force all the cold air to like the bed areas or just to the middle section, you can do that. A lot of them, they're permanently opened and you can usually turn them, but again, you're spreading out your unit and maybe not getting all the air in the right locations. Or if you want it to not have hot and cold spots, you can do that with this type of system. Again, all LED lights through here. Does have the sound system not only on the outside but the inside as well. And then I'll also point out that this guy does open up, so if you wanted some extra natural light in the camper, you have it, which is kind of cool. As we move into the bathroom here, you have a nice linen closet, a fairly deep one actually, and then this is that second fan. The reason I like the fan in the bathroom too is you'll notice if I close this guy, there's a gap up here. That's kind of nice because then you don't have to have your bathroom door open to be able to use that fan to pull air through the entire coach. Inside here, you'll notice that even as a guy, I have plenty of elbow room to move around. That's because of this neo-angled shower. You also have a spot for your soap and whatever else, and a couple little shelves to work with, and the skylight for extra light and extra height. I'm about 5'11", if you probably a couple inches above that, and then plus the skylight even gives you more space. And then in the sink area, you'll notice this is a little bit bigger sink. A lot of guys, they'll give you a sink half this big, which is hard to appreciate until you use one. And then you go to like wash your face or something like that, and you get water everywhere. This sink, that's a lot less likely to happen. You also have a toothbrush and soap holder, which again, I didn't really appreciate until I took a Rockwood out camping. I'm like, oh, where do I put all this stuff? And it's nice that they have a spot for all that stuff to make use of the space very efficiently. Again, instead of just a mirror, they actually have a medicine cabinet underneath there, more space underneath here, GFI protected outlets. They do a very good job, I feel like, not cutting corners and giving you a lot of features. So come on back here, this is the back bed area. One, I wanted to point out, this is like the teddy bear soft stuff, so it's very nice to even sleep on just this alone if you needed to. You do have a charge center right here, so you have two USB outlets as well as a 12 volt plug here, as well as a couple shelves to work with, coax cables, another plug in, and then this is that power outlet to be able to hook up that second fan slash light area if you need it. These guys do unzip, so if you wanted, and again, this is breathable material here. And then this guy opens up and has like a mesh outside so that you don't let the bugs in it. And then back here is not breathable, but you can unzip this guy and have just the mesh here. You can also unzip this mesh and use it as a emergency exit if you need to. So that's the 23IKSS Rockwood Roo. So if you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment below. Also, if you subscribe, we can tell you about all the new campers coming in. And then there's also that bell icon right next to the subscribe. You can click that and that'll notify you as we put new videos up. You can also email us. Our email address is sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. And check out our website, thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, and we have lots of other campers that we've just recently got in to show you. If this floor plan didn't quite meet what you needed something a little bit longer, a little bit lighter, we can help you out with that. We also take trades, we do financing, you name it. Again, my name's Mate. Thanks for joining us. Have a great day.